So in this series of SCAPS training videos, whereby I have put all the relevant introduction videos related to SCAPS. So I hope that you have all gone through those videos. So you are now well in place to start writing a research paper or to start gaining output from the SCAPS software. So if one try to simulate perovskite solar cell in SCAPS using SCAPS, it can be done. It is doable. Okay. So if I see the relevant paper on perovskite which came, so I will show you that paper and then we will talk about that paper and then we'll see what we can do in SCAPS simulation. Okay, for perovskite solar cells. So if you see, so this is the one paper which came way back in 2014. Okay, this is 2014. Way back in 2014. Okay. So what is the important thing here is that how they have simulated this is basically perovskite is a hybrid material, hybrid organic inorganic material. So they have considered perovskite as a thin film device. Okay, so then they have thin film device and then they have simulated accordingly. So numerically it has given output similar to the inorganic solar cells devices. Okay, so you can see out the Venn diagram figure, various sort of device lengths, various sort of device band gap, layer band gap, all those detail are being shown in the figure one. You can see relevant device parameters, relevant device parameter which can be used to replicate the same device. Okay, you can replicate the same device and then you can, using these, you can like replicate out, you can simulate out the band diagram of the device, perovskite device. So this particular sort of band diagram, whereby this is PIN kind of a structure. So HTM, which is P-type layer, this slope kind of layer, slant layer. So this is your perovskite layer. Okay, this slant layer, this is your perovskite layer. And then the TCO is your N-type layer or ETL kind of thing. So this is a device which is PIN type structure. PIN type of structure. Okay, so not a PN junction but a PIN junction. So this is how this band gap is almost replicating out a perovskite device. The IV curve in the figure B, the in figure C the QE plot. So these things are very much doable. Once you input these parameters, these things are very much replicatable. And now this figure is very tricky. So here what they are doing, efficiency evaluation as a function of diffusion length. So this cannot be directly replicated in SCAPS. So there's one trick. If you use that trick, you can replicate all those parameters, efficiency, VOC, fill factor, JSC, all those things can be replicatable. Okay. So so you can see as the diffusion length is higher, the efficiency is higher. So that's one simple point. The thing which need to focus upon here is that you see diffusion length is, they are simulating up to 2 micron. Where is the total width of the perovskite layer? The total width of the perovskite layer from this band diagram, if you see, it will not be more than 0.3 micron. Okay, not more than 0.3 micron. So around 0.3, so 0.5 micron. So efficiency will lie in this region. Okay, in this below 0 to 0.5 region only. Okay, somewhere the efficiency will lie. So that's how, like, how to generate this kind of graphs in SCAPS, like as a efficiency as a function of diffusion length or any other parameter, VOC, JSC, fill factor as a function of diffusion length. How to do that, I will tell you. And other things like this is with defect density, IV curve with defect density. So this is very much doable. Then efficiency or VOC as a function of defect densities for 2 different types of defect densities. So defect interface defect density at absorber HTM and at buffer absorber. So those things are highly doable, like very much now become trivial kind of things. Now this is generation rate with absorber thickness. So this is also direct simulation. Okay, this one is also a good simulation whereby they have simulated efficiency, thickness, and diffusion length. Okay, so various sort of diffusion length how does efficiency and thickness is varying. So this is a very good example of batch and recorder setup. So okay, so recorder setup they have put efficiency, and in the batch setup they have put thickness and diffusion length or defect density. So either you can put and then you can simulate out these kind of defect, these kind of plots. Okay, then this is biasing one. So this is again good example, and then this is the optimal thickness and diffusion length. So optimal thickness and diffusion length, how this parameter. So all these are doable, all these are doable. So this was, this paper was in 2014. So this paper is good paper, and you understood how you can like analyze a device performance. But this paper was in 2017, so almost 7 to 8 years ago. Nowadays if you do this kind of work, it may be, if you are like, if you present a good synopsis, a good analysis, you may be lucky to get the paper published. What we need now, we need either a good material or a new material, or you need a newer insight, new insight into a device functioning, device working. Then there is a chance of your papers to come. Okay, so to get paper published, you need to do some analysis. You need to bring out some information, some new information. Okay, so then the paper is like, so you see, this is also at the time in 2014, it was a good work, very good. I will say it's a very, very good work. Okay, so okay, I will show you some other paper on SCAPS itself. You see, this paper is again, so what I will do, I will just directly go to the figures only. I will explain figure only. So here this Venn diagram is again symbolizing perovskite solar cells. Okay, so then for figure 1, then the figure 2, you can see IV curves for different this may be some different this may be some your band offset, either balanced band offset or it, so EV, so this is balanced band offset. Okay, so HTM HTM perovskite junction they are simulating out. Okay, so they might have presented the curve also, so that let us see if they presented the plot. So this is HTM IV curve with for IV curve for different directly IV curve for different those this will be called valence band offset, so various for various valence band offsets. Okay, so basically what they are doing efficiency is a function of this valence band offset. So you can see in the positive side region this efficiency is maximizing, in the negative side region the efficiency is like going to zero. So all those plots are similar kind of things. So this is again a good analysis. So good analysis they are presenting, and they are like they got a good publication. Okay, so this is one paper. So what I want to say here is, what I want to like convey to you is, you do some sort of analysis to bring out the paper. Okay, so using this, so by seeing this, the example of this paper, which is a good one. What we can focus upon, we can either focus upon either optimizing the, say you optimize it. So what I will do, I will just go to the IV curve. So what I will do, I will just go to the IV curve, and then you can see PIN kind of structure, because this P type is red color layer, which is your HTL whole transport layer. This I is intrinsic greening type layer, N is your blue type ETL layer, electron transport layer. Okay, so this is your device. So you can just simulate it, once I simulate it, so you can see this kind of behavior it is showing. Okay, so one can go for simulation of interface recombination. Okay, one can go for simulation of optimization of say QE behavior evolution with respect to biasing, or the efficiency as a function of temperature, efficiency or recombination current as a function of temperature, recombination into the device as a function of say your illumination intensity. At lower intensity what will happen, at lower temperature what will happen, so what sort of defect will be dominant, or you can find out say which is suitable pair in the sense this is PIN junction. So instead of PIN. Let us change it and have from some. Basically, in Perovskite, we use Spiro as a P type layer, which is like organic and which is like which has a very low lifetime. So one can replace it by using some other material, say nickel oxide. So some suitable material, okay, and then checking out the efficiency or device working. Okay, so those things can be done. Those things like finding out various suitable junctions partner. So those things can be done, whereby you can do a good analysis and can have a papers. Okay, so here I have told you to show that how they have generated this particular parameter, this particular figure. Efficiency is a function of diffusion length. So how to do this? This is not directly doable because you will not find out any parameters. See, if I just go in here, no parameters. So if I select layer 2, which is layer 2, which is our I intrinsic layer or perovskite layer. So here nowhere it is shown that what is diffusion length. Nowhere you will find that diffusion length. Okay, so how to do that? How to vary diffusion length? Okay, so you will not find this. So this is not a direct simulation. So trick here it is this, that go for the device, go for the layer. Now here I have not put any defect, so just let me add any defect. So I will take whatsoever defect they are giving. So once I take that defect, now you see there is a one particular tau n. So this is lifetime. So carrier lifetime is 1000 nanosecond. Okay, for this particular defect. And then you see diffusion length, carrier diffusion length is 1.1 micrometer. Okay, carrier diffusion length is 1.1 micrometer. So 1.1, this is not 1.1, but 1.1 10 to the power 1. So this is around 10 micrometer. Okay, for this particular defect density. So now if I want to vary DLN, if I want to vary diffusion length, so what I need to do in this case, I need to vary the defect density. Okay, so what I will do, I will plot this function, plot this efficiency, not with ln but with defect density. Okay, so what I will go, I will do, I will go to, I will go to batch setup, I will go to layer 2, which is our perovskite layer, and then here I will go for defect 1, and then here I will go for defect density. Okay, so defect density I will go. And now I will go for 1E14, that is instead of 14, then 1E15, okay, then 1E16. So these three values I will check for defect density. Okay, so this is in turn equivalent to you see, if I put here 15 defect density instead of 15, so what is this? Now the diffusion length has halved, almost one third, so 3.6 micron only. Earlier it was 10 micron or 11 micron, now it is 3.6 micron only. Okay, now if I put 16, defect density is 16, except now the diffusion length is only 1.1 micron. Okay, so this way what I am doing, I am plotting efficiency as a function of diffusion length, and efficiency as a function of defect density, and for those defects in defect density, what is the diffusion length that can be put, and then in turn I can plot efficiency directly as a function of diffusion length. So I hope this has given you an idea like how to generate this kind of plot. Okay, so they have taken some couple of values. So this 1 micron will be it for our case. 1 micron is or around 1.1 micron is coming out for a defect density of 10 to the power 16. Okay, you can see here for so 10 to the power 16, when defect density is 10 to the power 16, our diffusion length is 1.1 micron. Okay, so around 1. So if I want to have lower lower value of diffusion length, I need to increase the defect density. So I put 17, then the defect density is 0.36 only. Okay, so this way you can see, this way we can change out, or we can vary that, we can have a control over the diffusion length. Okay, so now I hope this has given you an idea. Similarly, if you want to plot for tau naught, as a function of as a efficiency as a function of lifetime of a carrier. That can also be done because both are given here simultaneously. This is tau n or lifetime. This is now 1 nanosecond for this particular defect. So that's how you can do. Okay. So I have already told you what simulation can be done in SCAPS, using SCAPS, what you can do and how you can optimize the device configuration, and you can have some good analysis, and those things are there. Okay. So what I have did, I have given some of the videos on basic working of device. I have given basic working of device, how to optimize device, okay, defect tolerant device, those things, description of recombination in solar cells, and in turn you will get ideas for defect tolerant device configurations, device designs. Okay, so those things can be implemented in all sort of devices, all sort of materials, all sort of material systems, be it perovskite, be it newer inorganic materials, say SNS, FES, FES2, whatsoever it is. Okay, so please have my suggestion is that please have a basic understanding of working, device working. So if you want to say implement PERC cell, passivated emitter and passivated collector device kind of devices, HIT cells, or PI injection kind of perovskite cells, or P injection, P plus N junction kind of devices, or your thin films like PN, N plus kind of devices. So P plus N, N plus kind of devices. Okay, so those things can all, or you can simulate them out for your efficiency optimization, for your generation optimization, for your QE optimization, for your all sort of thing can be done. Okay, thank you for listening.